Why are ginger cats so special? You're about to discover four fascinating facts that will change how you see ginger cats forever. Fact 1. All ginger cats are tabbies. Here's a mind-blowing fact. Every ginger cat is a tabby. Even if they appear solid coloured, if you look closely, you'll see those subtle stripes and swirls, especially on their face and legs. This is all down to a fascinating genetic dance. Deep in a cat's DNA, there's a gene called the agouti gene. This gene is like a talented artist programmed to create tabby patterns, those classic stripes, swirls, and spots. Now there's another gene, the non-agouti gene, which acts like an eraser, trying to rub out those patterns, leaving a solid color. But here's the twist with ginger cats. The ginger gene, which determines their orange fur, throws a spanner in the works. The ginger gene is epistatic to the non-agouti gene, which is just a fancy way of saying it overrides it. So even if the eraser gene is trying its best, the ginger gene says, nope, the tabby patterns stay. So every ginger cat, no matter how solid they look, will have tabby markings if you look closely enough. This unerasable link to their ancestral tabby origins adds a dash of old school cool to their already captivating presence. Fact 2. There are roughly twice as many ginger males as there are ginger females. This all comes down to the genetics of ginger fur colour. Let's go back to basics with a quick crash course on feline DNA so we can unravel the secrets behind gender and ginger. Inside the cells of every cat, there are these tiny instruction manuals of DNA called chromosomes. Cats have 38 of these, which are organized into pairs, 19 from a cat's mum and 19 from dad. These manuals contain all the blueprints for building a cat, from their eye color to their love of naps. Now, one of those 19 pairs are what we call the sex chromosomes. They determine whether a cat will be male or female. There are two types of sex chromosomes, a large version termed the X chromosome and a small version termed the Y chromosome. As I'm editing this video, I've realized that the graphics I'm using for chromosomes all resemble the letter X, which could cause confusion. While chromosomes can look similar to this under a microscope, it's important to clarify that in this video, both the X and the Y chromosomes are represented by the same X-shaped graphic. I hope that clears things up. Females typically have two X chromosomes, while males typically have one X and one Y chromosome. Within chromosomes, there are even tinier sections called genes, which are the instructions for specific traits like fur color. And for these genes, there can be different options or versions. We call these alleles. In the case of cat fur color, the most influential gene is the orange gene, which has two versions, two alleles, one for orange fur and one for non-orange fur. And here's a key point. This gene is only located on the XX chromosome and not on its partner, the Y. This is pretty typical for the X chromosome. Think of the X chromosome as a detailed instruction manual for building a cat, packed with information on how to build various aspects of a cat. The Y chromosome, on the other hand, is more like a quick start guide, focusing mainly on the instructions specific to making a male cat. Over eons of evolution, the Y chromosome has become streamlined, like a minimalist guide with only the essential instructions for maleness. This means it has fewer pages for other traits like fur color. So while the X chromosome has a whole section on the orange gene with options for orange or non-orange fur, the Y chromosome doesn't have that section at all. Since female cats have two X chromosomes, they have two orange gene alleles programming for fur color. But males, with their single X, can only have one version of the ginger gene. Female cats with their two instruction sheets have three possible combinations. Double ginger, both sheets say ginger, so the cat is definitely ginger. Zero ginger, both sheets say not ginger, so the cat will be another color like black or brown. And semi-ginger, one sheet says ginger and the other says not ginger. This is where things get interesting. It's like the cat's instructions aren't clear on what color to be, so it ends up with a mix of ginger and other colors, creating a beautiful patchwork pattern like tortoiseshell or calico. Like my old girl Lucy here. Hey, sweetie. Male cats with their single instruction sheet have it easier. If their one instruction sheet says ginger, they're ginger. If the sheet says not ginger, they'll be another colour like black or brown. So now you can see why most torties are females. It's all about those X chromosomes. Males just can't get that mix of orange and non-orange fur because they only have one X chromosome. Now hopefully it'll also make sense why twice as many ginger cats will be male. Think of the ginger genetics like flipping a coin once for males. Heads they're ginger, tails are not. Versus flipping a coin twice for females. They need two heads to be ginger. 50% of male coin tosses will land heads, ginger, but only 25% of females will have both coins land heads and be ginger. The remaining 75% will be heads and tails, or tails and heads, or tails and tails. But let me dive into the weeds a little more, because when I was researching this topic, I found much of the info online seems to be wrong, and I really want to share with you what I learned. You often hear that a whopping 80% of ginger cats are male. While finding hard data to back this up is tricky, it's worth exploring the assumptions behind this claim. Many believe that a high proportion of ginger genes in the cat population explains the 80% figure. My wife Trace asked me to explain how the allele ratio affects the proportion of ginger males, and to tell you the truth, I didn't do a very good job, and that's because my assumptions were wrong. It turns out that the balance between ginger males and females is influenced by the ratio of orange and non-orange alleles in the cat population. But in a surprising turn of events, it's actually a scarcity of the ginger allele that tips the scales towards a higher proportion of ginger males. Less ginger cats overall, but a higher proportion of the male. To achieve 80% male prevalence among ginger cats, there actually needs to be 3 non-orange alleles to every 1 orange allele. Here's the calculation. For the rest of you who have somehow stuck with me through this, let's move on to fact 3. Fact 3. Lentigo, the ginger freckle. Have you ever noticed those adorable black spots on your cat's nose and lips? Those are called lentigo, or as I like to call them, ginger freckles. Now these aren't like human freckles, which are caused by the sun. Lentigo in cats is all about their genes. Ginger cats have a high concentration of pheomelanin. That's the pigment responsible for their fiery fur. And it seems that the genes that control pheomelanin production also influence the activity of melanocytes, the cells that produce melanin, the pigment responsible for those dark spots. In ginger cats, these melanocytes tend to cluster together, creating those adorable lentigo spots. I've always had a soft spot for lentigo, especially because one of my favourite ginger boys, Nandu, had a nose full of them. Here he is, trying to steal Marmite on toast from my girlfriend back in the day. Luckily, she had a soft spot for both him and me, and we've been married for almost 20 years. So next time you see those ginger freckles, remember they're not just cute, they're a unique feature linked to your cat's beautiful orange coat. Fact 4. Ginger cats are bigger than other cats. You might have noticed that male ginger cats often seem to be quite big guys, while ginger females tend to be more petite. This size difference isn't unique to gingers though. All cats, like many other animals, exhibit something called sexual dimorphism, which means males and females have distinct physical differences. Take lions for example. The males sport those majestic manes, while the females don't. And not only that, but male lions can weigh up to twice as much as females. That's like a 4kg cat facing off against an 8kg one. Talk about a size difference. Now in domestic cats, the differences aren't as dramatic as in their wild lion cousins, but they're still there. Males are generally larger and heavier than females. On average, they weigh about 10 to 15% more than females. Think of it like this. If the average female cat weighed 4kg, the average male would be closer to 4.5kg. Not a huge difference, but noticeable. And here's where things get even more interesting with ginger cats. Remember how we talked about the X chromosome shenanigans that led to more ginger males? Well, this skewed ratio plays a part in why we perceive ginger cats as being larger overall. It's a simple numbers game. More males mean more chances to encounter those big beefy ginger boys. And there may be more to the story. Some researchers suggested that ginger males might be even slightly larger than males of other colors, and ginger females might be slightly smaller than other females. It's like the ginger gene might add a little extra oomph to the males and a touch of daintiness to the females. Next time you encounter a ginger giant or petite princess, remember it's all part of their unique charm and the fascinating interplay of genetics and gender in the feline world. So now you're in the know about ginger cats. But hold on, there's more. If you're curious about how to make sure your ginger cat is living their best life, I've got just the video for you. It's packed with tips on everything from playtime to pampering. Check it out right here. If you're currently gingerless, don't worry. There are heaps of ginger cats out there looking for loving homes. I'm currently on the lookout, so watch this space. And hey, before you go, let me know in the comments how many ginger cats have graced your life. Were they big and bold or small and sassy? Did they have the ginger freckle? I'm really keen to hear your stories. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the comments.